What's going on, gamers? Today, we're going to be going over the Title Manager plugin, how to install it on your Apex Minecraft server, and even how to use it. Before we get into this tutorial, don't forget to give this video a like, subscribe, and click the notification bell so you can stay up to date on every video we upload, just like this one. Look, we know that even though you put in hard work and time on your server, sometimes it can just feel dull or boring in game because of the lack of personalization and customizable features in regular Minecraft servers, which leads owners to find plugins to fix that. For instance, when you're using Tab to view the connected players on your server, it doesn't have any headers or footers by default. Changing that requires a plugin called TitleManager, which allows you to control the player list, among other things such as a scoreboard, action bar messages, announcements, and welcome title messages. Additionally, adding cool effects like text animation and color changes makes your server's appearance stand out when compared to default Minecraft, welcoming players and giving them useful information about the server or world is going to make it as professional as Hypixel through the server plugin's abilities. Our first step is we're going to need to download the plugin. Go ahead and hop onto their Spigot page, and from there, there's going to be a blue download button. You can click on that to start the download. And then after your file is done downloading, you can click or drag this to an easy to find spot like your desktop or a folder that you made just for this. Once your file is downloaded, you can go ahead and hop onto your Apex server panel. We recommend that you stop your server before proceeding and wait until it turns fully offline. Then once your server's offline, go ahead and click on FTP file access. Then log in with your information. And once you're logged in, go ahead and find your plugins folder and then click into it. And once you're in your plugins folder, go ahead and click on upload on the top left corner. Then open up that folder where you downloaded Title Manager to earlier, and click and drag the file over to the right hand side of your upload page and wait for it to fully upload 100% and 1 out of 1 files. Then once it's fully uploaded, go ahead and click on the name of your server at the top of the page. And from here, you can either click on start or restart to get your server up and running. Title Manager is surprisingly easy to use. I personally don't consider myself a server genius, but as I was making this video and recording the files, I found that it was super easy to configure. Most of the usage for the plugin is actually in the configuration files, which is a little confusing at first because of the formatting. However, commands are included in the plugin to send specific announcements and messages in game rather than using the automatic function in the files. We're going to go over some commands because it's just easy to look at, and /tm /bc /parameters /message sends a title broadcast message to every player on the server. When I was using this, /tm /bc/ and then just the message worked for me as well. /tm /abc/message sends a title action bar message to every play in game. And /tm /sb/toggle enables or disables the scoreboard from the plugin. You might also need an additional plugin, as this didn't really work for me with just Title Manager. And /tm /reload reloads the entire plugin's configuration, which is good for applying new changes if you're in the config files and you don't really want to fully restart your server. You can learn more about commands and parameters on Title Manager's official Command Wiki webpage, which of course we're going to link in the description of this video, along with any other links that you'll ever need for Title Manager. To start off, we're going to hop over to the Title Manager's generator page that we've linked in our written guide, which is linked in the description of this video. This written guide is going to have every link you need, along with pictures and written instructions on this video specifically. Once you're on this generator page, then select an animation type to the left. There's only 5 on here, and they're all super good to use. Once you found the one that you want, type your text in the animation input field. This process is going to be the same for each type, so it doesn't matter which one you select. Once you select it, you can edit stuff like the speed ticks and other options depending on the animation that you select. To the right, there's also going to be a button that says Generate. When you're finished designing your animation, you can click on that. Once it's generated, you can click on Static Output and copy the contents in this text field. Then, once you've copied it, you can head back onto your server panel. And then you can click on FTP File Access and Login. And then go ahead and find your plugins folder. Then click into Title Manager. Then click into the Animations folder. And from here, you can click on New File in the top left so that we can make the animations file. Then you can name it whatever you want and paste in your generated animation into the file. Then you can click on Save. You can even learn more about animations on the Title Manager's official animation wiki page, which of course is going to be linked into the written guide. Applying any changes to Title Manager requires you to access its configuration file. You use that to implement animations, custom messages, TABLIST design, scoreboard changes, and other neat features. To head into the configuration file, you're just going to hop onto your Apex server panel, and on the left-hand side, click on FTP File Access, and then you're going to log in with your information. Then you're going to find your plugins folder, and then you're going to click into it. And then you're going to find your Title Manager folder and click into that. From here, there's going to be a config.yml file. You can just click Edit to the right of it. And in that file, you can choose to locate what features you want to implement or change. All the features are split up into their respective categories and sections in the file. We're going to look at some of them on the file, and we're going to look at some video footage of them in-game as well. There's TABLIST, one of the best features Title Manager offers. This controls the tab or player list. You can use that to display your server's name, the world's time, online players, and other information. Inside of the config.yml file, this is found in the player list section, which has a header and a footer subsection. And then there's the welcome title. This shows up when a player joins a server. They see this message. If a brand new player joins, then a similar message appears as well. You can begin editing that in the file's welcome title section. Everything under the first join option is used for players that are newly joined to your server. Then there's the scoreboard section. It's another great feature from Title Manager, and it can display the player's username, ping, money, server's name, and other useful information. You can control that in the scoreboard section of the file. The title option is the server's name line, while everything else is the contents of the scoreboard. And then there's announcement. Just like the welcome title, these title messages that appear in-game are usually appeared at specific times. They're located in the announcer section of the config.yml. It has two styles of announcements, titles and action bars. You can change them accordingly and add more if you want. Title Manager allows you to fully customize your Minecraft server from all the available options that it has. You can edit the tab list, scoreboard, announcements, and welcome messages. All of that is done through the configuration file of the plugin in the FTP panel. If you want to make your server look fancier, then using the animation generator is a wonderful tool to do so. You can make new files for animations in the plugins folder. Then you can implement them through the main config file. Now we hope you understand how to use Title Manager and how easy it can be to make your server look just that cooler. Well folks, we hope you enjoyed this video, and as always, we hope you have lots of fun.
Thanks for watching. If you want to see more great content like this, then subscribe or click these videos. Until next time, gamers.